25 years after the counterculture hit its zenith at the Woodstock Music and Arts Festival, the second wave of the American counterculture was blossoming right up the road in Parksville, New York. Unsigned artists like Blues Traveler, Fish, and the Spin Doctors flocked to the new hippie haven 90 miles from New York City. The fame and success that these artists would soon experience brought a lot of things with it, but none so rare as the complete artistic and personal freedom they experienced for a brief time at the Arrowhead Ranch. One of the main cogs in the counterculture artistic machine was legendary concert promoter Bill Graham, who had discovered and promoted more of the talent that defined the 1960s and 70s than all his competitors combined. In 1989, Bill Graham's son David was roommates at Columbia University with a young concert promoter named Tom Gruber. Tom had been promoting the Blues Traveler, who were at the center of a community of artists and musicians in New York City that were about to emerge as the next wave in American popular culture. All of these paths converged when Tom Gruber cornered Bill Graham in the back of a limousine and convinced him that the Blues Traveler were the next big thing. After meeting Ken and Michelle, Bill realized he had a perfect opportunity to put his son in charge of a venture of his own. The project would be managed by David Graham under a new arm of Bill Graham Presents, known as Music Unlimited.